Let's start with the quarter circle. Then we will insert the point at the arc of this quarter circle so that it divides the arc into two identical pieces. Now, using this point, we will inscribe the half circle into our quarter circle just as shown in the sketch. If we know that the distance between the center of our quarter circle and the intersection point between the arc of the half circle and the radius of the quarter circle is equal to 8, is it possible for us to calculate this red shaded area of the difference between the quarter circle and the inscribed half circle? If you want to try this interesting problem for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check your solution. Alright, so let's solve this problem. First, we will mark the center of our quarter circle as O. Then we can mark the center of our half circle as C. Now we will also mark the intersection points between the diameter of the half circle and the quarter circle as A and B, and we will mark the left intersection point as D. Now let's take a look at the line AC. It will represent the radius of our half circle, which we can label as R. We can rotate this radius and get that the point CB must also be equal to R. Now we will rotate this radius once more to the point D. And you can notice that the angle at the point D must be 90-degree angle. We know this by using the tangent of a circle theorem, which states that if we pull the radius to the intersection point between the tangent and the circle, this radius will always be perpendicular to that tangent line. So we can use this in our case here, since the line OD represents the tangent of our half circle. Now let's continue on by pulling the line from the point B that is perpendicular to the radius of our half circle. And let's mark this intersection point as E. Now you can notice that we have formed this quadrilateral OABE. Let's isolate it for the moment. You can see that the angle at the point O is also a 90-degree angle, since this angle represents the central angle of our quarter circle. Now we can notice that the lines OA, DC, and EB are perpendicular to the line OE, which means that those three lines are actually parallel. That will lead us to conclude that this quadrilateral is actually right trapezium. Now we can notice that the point C is dividing the leg AB of our trapezium into two identical segments with the length of R. This means that the line DC will actually represent the midline or the median of this right trapezium. So now, knowing that the median always divides the legs of the trapezium into two identical segments, we can conclude that the segments OD and DE must have the same length of 8. Now, with this new knowledge, let's go back to our previous sketch. We can now easily conclude that the line OE must be equal to 16. Now, we will again clear our image and we will label the radius of our big quarter circle as capital R. We can rotate this radius to the point B. And in this way, we have formed this right triangle OEB. Now, since the point B is midpoint at the arc of our quarter circle, this means that the radius OB will divide the central angle of this quarter circle into two identical angles of 45 degrees. This leads us to conclude that the angle at the point B of this right triangle must also be 45 degree angle. So that means that this triangle is actually isosceles right triangle, and it will represent the half of the square with the side 16. This of course means that the line EB must also be equal to 16, since that is the side of our square, and more importantly, the radius of this quarter circle will represent the diagonal of this square, so that means that its length will be equal to 16 square root of 2. Now, let's go back to the previous sketch and try to find the radius of our small inscribed half circle. We can do this by noticing the line DE with the length of 8. We can slide this line to the point C, and we can mark the intersection point between this line and the line EB as F. You can now see that we have formed this really nice right triangle CBF. Now, let's again clear our image. You can see that the line EB has the length of 16, and the length of the line DC is equal to the length of the line EF and has the value of R. This leads us to conclude that the line FB must be equal to 16 minus R. Now, let's go back to our previous sketch and let's form the Pythagorean theorem using this right triangle CBF. We can say that the hypotenuse CB squared must be equal to the leg CF squared plus the leg FB squared. Now we can substitute our values and we can put everything to the square, and of course we can expand our second term on the right by using the square of binomial to get to the following. Now, from here we can simplify r square and get that 32r is equal to 320, which means that the radius of our small inscribed half circle must be equal to 10. Now, we can find our red shaded area as the difference between the area of the quarter circle with the radius of capital R and our small inscribed half circle with the radius of small r. We can write this down as a formula where our red area is equal to the capital R squared pi over 4, that represents the area of the quarter circle, minus the small r squared pi over 2, that represents the area of our inscribed half circle. Now, we can substitute both of our radii and get the following. Then we will put everything to the square, and we can simplify by losing the fractions to get to the following. From here, we can conclude that our red shaded area is equal to 78 pi squared units, which actually really nicely approximates to 245 squared units, and this is our solution. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this interesting problem. If you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.